president for expecting us. For our first set of questions, and we're going to have a little bit of a party piece just to let you know how it's all going to work, and our judges will have only nice things to say to Tommy at the end of every act. That will be worth listening to. This little fellow's going to have a thing or two to say as well. First contestant we're going to speak to tonight, Lady Goo Goo. You're looking beautiful.
Well, thank you very much.
I love your accent. Where are you from?
I'm from Piscataway, New Jersey.
Jersey?
Yeah.
There's some talk of a banana boat company. Any truth in that?
Yeah, ever since I was a little girl, I really wanted to own a successful banana boat company, you know? But like, the market over there in New Jersey is kind of saturated with banana boat companies. So I thought I'd come here to the world's best known banana republic to start up my own.
That's what you're calling Mundorm.
Yeah. Well, Ireland is a banana republic, so.
Yeah. But the boats could work pretty well here as well. You haven't found a boat to launch the boat.
Yeah, I'm not that much good at surfing, you know. I can't stand up on that waxy board, you know. But I'm pretty good with something between my legs, you know.
Sure, I know what you're saying. I just wanted to teach you what to do with a board between your legs.
Yeah, well, if somebody would be kind enough to do that for me, I'd really appreciate it.
20 volunteers later on tomorrow morning, maybe a nice fresh day in the Northwest. Lady Goo Goo, any relation to Lady Gaga?
Yeah, she's a cousin of mine, you know, second cousin once removed.
Have you written any songs particularly like hers, though?
Well, we co-wrote a few songs, but she's after taking on one of our numbers, you know, called Poker Face, so that's what I'm gonna do just for a little while.
There's a bit of bad blood there, is there now, over that? You wrote the song together, she's made it a hit.
No, you know, I'm not really interested in material things as such, you know, so if Gaga wants to go away and make a big hit out of that, that's okay with me.
New Jersey, the Rose of Tralee section, you went forward for that. What happened there?
That's right. Well, you know, that's kind of unfortunate, you know, because I was doing pretty well in that competition, you know, and I got up on stage for the New Jersey round of the World of Tralee qualifiers, and like I was talking to the compere just like I'm doing with you now, but when I flipped my hair, he saw one of my sideburns. He didn't think that was so cool, so I got kicked out. I thought that was pretty unfair, you know.
That's the end of that, man. That's rough on it. Lion Tamer, what's going on over there? What's one of your hobbies?
Yeah, well, you know, a lot of people when they're young, they dream of, like, you know, leaving and joining the circus. And I did leave and I did join the circus. And, you know, the one thing I could do, the one thing I was good at was sticking my head in a lion's mouth. You know, I wasn't much good at nothing else, like, so I did that for a long time. And when I started getting, like, a bit of stubble, they threw me in for the bearded lady, too. So, you know, I was double jobbing for a little while, but I really liked that, but I had to move on, you know.
You like the double jobbing, or you like the lion too?
Well, I did like the double jobbing so much. The lions were okay, but geez, you know, a girl can only do so much.
You dislike most animals, but that includes our furry friend here. Like, you like big cats, I've been told.
Yeah, you know, I'm looking at that and I'm starting to reconsider, because with a bit of mint sauce, that thing can go a long way.
We just had you this evening, right? One of your dreams would be to present Telly Bingo. What's the story of that?
Yeah, you know, people would compare me a lot of times to that guy who used to present the Telly Bingo here on RTE, you know? So I think of going back to this backstage side, you know, maybe presenting something successful like that back there on one of the network channels, you know? Because I think I got what it takes to say, like, hello, Legs 11, Two Fat Ladies, all that sort of thing. You know, I'm pretty good at numbers and stuff, you know, so.
There's a tip for you. If you have a little word of Margaret there, sit in the middle, Works with Ocean FM, Radio Bingo every morning. What do you think? Could you do it?
Well, Margaret's pretty good, you know. I think people might have a problem understanding my accent if I went on the radio, you know what I'm saying?
No.
Let me rephrase that. I think people might have a problem understanding my accent if I went on the radio, you know what I'm saying?
No, I know what you're saying. Okay. Let them get that cleared up. You're going to hear a little bit of a party piece now, as you mentioned. Poker Face.
That's right, yeah!
Take it away.